Almost 6 months back, on 30th November 2022, ChatGPT was released. And I guess no one at that point of time would have thought that AI wave would hit us so quickly. And definitely, while it offers a lot of opportunity to innovate, it is imposing a lot of threats and a lot of job cuts. So in this video, we'll talk about 5 IT jobs which might face immediate risk if this whole AI wave picks up. And I want that we need to be prepared, we need to be aware of this wave well in advance so that we could change ourselves, we could move to a different career trajectory. So in this video, we will talk about those jobs, but we will also talk about some of the moves you could take in your career to safeguard yourself. And eventually, don't worry, almost every sector would get hit, but then people who would be flexible, who would be, you know, adaptable to this situation, who would learn continuously, would always ride this AI wave. So let's start with our very first job. So the first job category is customer support. And before we go to this job category, I'm assuming that you by now know a bit about ChatGPT. But if you want me to create some basic video on the fundamentals of ChatGPT, do let me know in the comment section by liking this video and commenting, because obviously we discuss various topics in IT industry, but this is fairly new to all of us. So if you want me to make one, do let me know. So customer support representatives are at risk because a lot of the work which they do, especially at level one support, which is primarily to deal with the initial inquiries of the customer, understanding the problem, logging the ticket, providing some basic documentation, all of that work is now already being sent to these chatbots. So if you log into any support portal nowadays, the first interaction generally happens through a chatbot. For example, I purchase milk from one of the food delivery apps, and whenever I want to order anything, pause a delivery, do anything of that sort, everything is done through a chatbot solution. No representative comes and talks to me unless I need some advanced level support. And also in customer support, I'm specifically focusing on level one support, because with level two, level three support, you still need human expertise a lot. So it's not that chatbot would completely replace the whole customer support domain. It's only where you have repetitive actions with minimal human interactions, that is where these bots, these AI solutions could come in. So we need to be aware of it. So the next job is of a data entry professional. I still remember the days where your typing speed used to be a very important criteria for your selection in such roles. So basically, data entry job is picking data from your files, from your documents, and feeding it into some computer system. For example, taking some campaign data or some marketing data and entering it into your CRM systems or your ERP systems. So all those kind of things used to be done by, you know, data entry professionals. So data entry jobs are at risk because it does not involve a lot of human interaction and it's repetitive. So there are products which could actually crawl a website, take the data and then feed it into a system. Everything could now be automated. So this, you know, if you're working in this kind of a field, then there is a path which you need to take. It's a good path. Okay, there are ways where you could transform. We'll talk about it a bit, but this is not safe as of now. And all these jobs are at immediate risk. I'm not saying that rest all jobs are secure, but if we have to come today and see that what all could be replaced in the next 2 years, then these jobs are at a higher risk. So now let's move on to the third job category. So the third job category is of an IT help desk, and it is very close to category one, which is customer support, but there's a difference. You are well aware of it. IT help desk generally deals with the technical queries of the customer or the internal users, because you will have internal IT teams as well. So remember the days when you used to forget your password or you need to reset your passwords and you used to call your level one help desk support? Now I don't think you do that. All of this is getting automated. So if you are someone who's just sitting at a level one support, you need to move up the ladder at a level two support or a level three support, where you have more subject matter expertise around a product. If you are dealing with operating systems, then go deep into operating systems. If you're working in the field of data, then you need to up your game and understand how to troubleshoot level two and level three support queries. So level one support guys need to create a niche in a particular technical domain. So now let's go to our fourth category. So whenever a company hires a set of employees, new employees, freshers, they go through the initial learning program, right? And that program is conducted by the IT onboarding or training team, where you will have your technical trainers, your process coordinators, who would make sure that the transition to the new company is smooth. Now, this profile is also getting impacted by AI, because now there are products which could completely automate this whole experience, this whole journey. So there are products which are offering LMS platforms, learning management system platforms, which are improving the learning experience. So a new employee could simply log into that particular product or service, and the whole journey could be automated with minimal human intervention here and there. So again, if you are a IT trainer or if you are into IT onboarding team, then you need to think of other options, or you could also think of going to a very specific niche which could not be, so everything cannot be taught by a product, right? So if you are into training, then obviously you might need to go into an advanced niche into your whole technical area, because not everything could be replaced in all these categories. Not 100% replacement would happen. Okay, there would be certain percentage of jobs which would be, you know, which would be replaced. So even in this case, if you are a trainer or if you are someone who's in the onboarding team, you have to understand what you could add into your profile which could either help you move to a different role or persist with this with this profile for the long term. So now let's quickly learn about our fifth and the last job category. So the last one is technical writer. Everything remains the same as far as AI role is concerned. But to understand quickly what technical writer does, the technical writers create documentations, very good documentations for companies. For example, there is an IT system. So they will understand that IT system and they'll try to create a user manual or a user guide understanding that system step by step. They'll create documentation, a different kind of document. It could be technical documentation, it could be process documentation. But with natural language processing, AI could replicate this now. And that's why we might need to think on different career paths or trajectories if you are a technical writer. So guys, enough of sad news, okay? Now let's talk about some pragmatic steps we could take from today to safeguard ourselves and to evolve into a professional who won't be even touched or scratched by this wave. Okay, we could always work on ourselves, right? We cannot change external factors. What we could change is how we are growing internally. So now for every category, I will give few pointers. These are just pointers. I have not worked on these areas, so you know better what you need to do. Okay, so I'll just give you some pointers, and then you need to understand where you want to go and how you would create your particular edge in this overall AI situation. Okay, so let's start. So people working in customer support need to work on their interpersonal skills, because what still AI can't do is to create that human to human interaction and create that emotional empathetic relationship with the customer. So if you are good in your communication skills, if you are good in your emotional intelligence, then you will always have an edge. It's a soft skill, but a very important skill in every area of our work life. So work on that. The second is advanced problem solving. As I said, customer support has different levels, right? So you need to get into advanced problem solving. Identify the areas within your team where you could enter and work on things which has a which has a niche. So take for example, if you are a level one support for a SaaS product like Salesforce. Now you know Salesforce, you know that it is a CRM based CRM solution, right? So why can't you go from level 1 to level 2, level 3, understand what is Salesforce, get certified into Salesforce certification for support, and then create that edge. So that's my advice for you. And the last one is customer support and customer success teams are two different teams, but eventually you could get into customer success. Customer success teams work after a new customer has been onboarded. And they make sure that the whole customer journey while using the product is smooth. For example, if the sales team sells a product and then the customer is now ready to use that product, then the customer success team would pitch in and make sure that that whole customer journey is a nice experience. So suppose there's a sales deal which is closed, a customer has bought your product or service and now they have started using it, then as a customer success team, you would ensure that you're talking to different functions within your company to make sure that the customer experience is good. or great rather. So because you have customer experience, you could apply for roles in this area. So the people who are working in data entry field have an edge because they have a clear path where they go. I won't give you too many advice. I'll simply tell you that data is what is driving the whole AI revolution, right? So as a data entry professional, you already have the vibe of how data works to an extent, right? Now you need to up your game. You need to start to get into data analysis where you will work with the business, understand how a data analyst work. If you want to understand the difference between data analyst, data engineer, data scientist, I have created a dedicated video for that, so you could check that out. But then there is a very clear progression path for you, so there is no confusion. So you need to learn programming, guys, because programming is that edge which will create a difference, a huge difference between you and other candidates. So for example, in the field of data, you can learn a language like Python and you could use that into your data journey. So for data entry professionals, I will recommend this. But as I said, IT industry is a big industry, you know yourself better. So explore your own path. So for IT helpdesk, there could be several options because in technology, you could explore any of the paths. You could go into AI and ML right now. You could take on a course, you could go for a certification and try to get into a team which supports artificial intelligence and ML projects. You could understand what is ML ops. You could get into cybersecurity or cloud operations, for example. So try to move out of your level one IT help desk support and get into any of these fields. I think you would be fine. You are already technical. You are already working on certain things which are already complex to an extent. I'm not saying that this is a very easy job to do. So as I have said before, you need to create your specialization into a particular area and then move into that area quickly. So guys, if you are in IT onboarding team, then you need to learn more about LX design, which is learning experience design, where you would learn how to create a learning experience for the users, which is goal-oriented and human-centered. So you might need to understand how you could create interactive content, how you could create that learning experience where user could just immerse himself or herself and come out with more knowledge and more information. So understand this and then understand what all other options you have. So if you are a technical writer, there are some options which looked interesting to me. The first one is social media marketing. You have been writing technical content, so you do have technical acumen to an extent, right? So you could go into a social media marketing team and write online content, write technical blogs, contribute into your technical online communities and things like that. You could also contribute to your social media campaigns, for example. So that's one option. The second option, which is more related to your area, is redefine your domain expertise. So you might be documenting for an IT system for years, right? So why can't you gain subject matter expertise in that particular domain and become a subject matter expert? So that is a very interesting value proposition because it will, you know, it is easier to crack being a technical writer. This is what I feel, and feel free to differ. And the last one is content strategy. Every company has a team which works on content strategy. What kind of content will be created online and offline, social media content and everything. So being a technical writer, you could get into content strategy as well. So guys, yes, these are some options. As I said in the beginning, this AI wave is coming and these are some jobs which are at risk. But as I said, this is not going to erode all the jobs. It is only going to erode or replace some percentage of these jobs, and people who are able to learn, who are informed, who are watching videos like these and are prepared won't get impacted. And that I could say with a lot of confidence. So guys, work on your skills, keep learning. I'm learning, I'm sharing my knowledge with you guys, whatever I'm learning. So continue to learn, continue to adapt. This AI wave is there. We can't change it. Everyone is impacted, including people like me, you, everyone. So what best we could do? We could learn, we could evolve ourselves and become better professionals. And at the end of the day, if you look at history, every time any challenge has come, you see COVID 2 years back, right? We evolved, we came out of it. Similarly, we will find a way to make AI, to make all these artificial intelligence technologies and products our friend, which could enable and boost our productivity rather than making these are enemies. So we'll find a way around it. It is very new, it's still emerging. A lot is not known about all this. So yes, we are all traveling together, we are all on this journey, and if we help each other and if we work as a community, definitely we'll be safe and we'll be happy. So with that, guys, I hope you liked this video. If you did, please hit the like button, subscribe, comment on this video. This is an AI video which I have created specifically on your request. So if you liked it, let me know what else you would want to know in this field. Other videos from cybersecurity, networking, data would continue to come. So until next time, guys, keep learning, keep sharing all your knowledge, and yes, keep hustling. Bye for now.